So,
So, if you can confirm, please.
sir.
Yes, sir,
Yes,
it's
sir.
visible.
Okay, fine, fine. Thank you. Welcome back to the class here. So now this is lecture number 4. So in this class, so we will be discussing about source transformation and source shifting and related problems. And in the last class we have discussed about the problems or the circuit analysis through KVL and KCL. And I have floated a few practice problems also. I hope you are going with them. So you have 1 week time. So within that you need to finish. Okay. So next, coming to the today's topic, as I told, we will be discussing about the source transformation and source shifting and related problems. Okay. So let me just give you the overview of behavior of voltage and current in a series and parallel circuits. Okay. So already I have documented these conditions. So here now, if you consider the requirements, so let me just change the pointers here. So here I have already given you the details. So this circuit, so it indicates how we can define the voltage in the nth resistor. So we can consider the series combination here. So I have considered a voltage source. This is the voltage source what we have. So this is the voltage source what we have, and in series with this we have n number of resistors connected in series. So I have assumed that there is a loop current I which is flowing in a clockwise direction, and these V1, V2 and till up to Vn, they are the voltage drops across each respective resistors. Okay. So now if you apply KVL, so what we get? We get first source is this, so that is minus V plus V1 plus V2 till Vn equal to 0. And if you rewrite and if you substitute V1, so if I consider this here, so we know V1 is this value. So this V1 is replaced with, or it can be replaced with V1 equal to I into R1, that is the voltage drop definition across R1. Okay. And similarly, as you can see, since the current is common everywhere in each of the drops, so we can take current as a common factor, and you can define the current, total current in the series connected elements will be same, that is equal to V divided by equivalent resistance. So equivalent resistance here is what? Equivalent resistance here, it is nothing but, so this is nothing but you have the total equivalent resistance of R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus so on up to Rn. So that is the summation here. So from this you can or you will be able to define both current and as well as the voltage. So what about if I am interested in a voltage across a particular element? So if I want to define a voltage across a particular element, so that can be defined in this way. So you can consider V1 is equal to, so what we have written, V1 equal to V divided by R equivalent into, so this way you can consider here V1 is nothing but total voltage, that is the main source voltage. So now I can call this as main voltage, divided by equivalent resistance of the circuit, then multiplied by the resistance of interest, means resistance where across we want to calculate the voltage. So this is the interest point. So similarly, if I want to calculate the voltage across R2, so I can replace V1 by V2 equal to V divided by R equivalent. This is going to remain same. So only this thing will change. So in general, how we can write this? So we may write this as something like, for any nth resistor, we can write Vn is equal to total voltage divided by equivalent resistance multiplied by that particular resistance value. Okay, so these things are required in the coming classes, so I am telling these things. So next, similarly, if you look into for the current, behavior of the current in a parallel circuit and as well as the behavior of the voltage. So here I have taken a circuit where we have the main current source or the source current. So I can call this as the main current source. Then it is connected to parallel combinations of R1, R2 till Rn. And in each of the resistance R1, R2 till Rn, we have the currents I1, I2 and In. So this current is entering at node X and it is leaving at node Y. So if you consider all these conditions, so all these options, what we have, so here we have this, sorry, so we have this option here, that is presently we have R1, R2 and R3, and here this is the node X and this is the node Y. So in order to calculate the current through each resistor Rn, R2, R1, so we know that the behavior of voltage and current, voltage will be same across the parallel elements and current will be different in them. Okay, so if you consider, if you apply KCL at node X, then we have one current which is entering, that is Is, and all other currents we have assumed at leaving, that is I1, I2 till In. Okay, so if you consider the definition of I1 from Ohm's law, we can write I1 is equal to V1 by R1. So this is the definition of current. So V1 is nothing but the voltage drop across R1. Similarly, we can have V2 drop across R2, then Vn, which is the drop across Rn. So like that we can consider, and if you solve, and here if you use a condition, that is if you use a condition that V1 and V2 all are same, so we can use instead of V1 and V2 and V3 till Vn, wherever they exist, they can be replaced by a V only, because the voltage is same. So the same thing, if you use it in the analysis here, So what we get is 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 equal to V is equal to V multiplied by 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 till 1 by Rn, or simply you can write in this way also, right? So this is nothing but what now, if I want to calculate the current through any nth branch. So to make it more simple, I can take this example here. So in general, if you consider there are only two resistance connected in parallel, that is R1 and R2, okay? So in such cases, how to find the current through R1 and current through R2? So with a similar approach, if you apply KCL at node X, we get I1 plus I2. And if you define what is I1, I1 is nothing but, if you apply the Ohm's law, total voltage divided by the resistance. So where we are interested to calculate the current, we are interested in calculating the current through R1. So the total voltage divided by R1, you can write, where total voltage is nothing but what? So total voltage is nothing but V is equal to, so this can be replaced by this equation. So how? So this we have seen in the previous section here. So what is the voltage? Multiplication of R1, R2 till Rn. So there we have only two resistance. So we get R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2 multiplied by main current source. So this can be replaced in the place of V. Then multiplied by 1 by R1. So this R1 and this R1 will get cancelled out. So we will be left with what? IS. So that is the main current IS. You can call main current IS multiplied by opposite resistance. This is the opposite resistance. So this one is the opposite resistance divided by R1 plus R2. So this I can call it as summation of total resistance of the network. So similarly, suppose if you have one more resistor here like R3. So what will change now? So here you will get, again if you want to calculate I1, so here you will get R2 into R3, here you will get R1 plus R2 plus R3. So this we have to remember properly, okay? So is that clear? So if anybody has any doubts, you are free to ask. So if you have any questions, please proceed, otherwise I will go to the next slide. Yes, are you able to hear me? If you have any questions, please ask. Is that clear? Hello, is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so if you have any questions, please ask, please be interactive. Okay, so I hope the things are clear for you.
Yes, sir. Okay,
so we'll go to the next thing here. So So now we will go to the next topic of interest, that is source transformation and source shifting. See, based on these things, you will get many questions in the examination also, and it will help the things in a better way. So first thing is, what is source transformation and why it is required? So if I consider these things, okay, see, first thing is, if you talk about the source transformation, so this source transformation is nothing but in a given circuit, we will be able to convert a voltage source into an equivalent current source, or vice versa, that is, a current source can be converted into a voltage source. So why these things are required here? Because till now we are familiar with KVL and KCL, right? So you may see that for some circuits, so it will be difficult to apply KVL and KCL only. So we can reduce the complexity of the circuit by using source transformation. Then we can apply the KVL and KCL. Suppose if you have something like 10 loops or 10-20 nodes in a given circuit, so then that you can convert it into simple form, and then you can proceed. Okay. So how it is done, we'll see. So if you consider some network here, which is having a voltage source in series with its internal resistance or some external resistance. So this is some kind of network, this part here. It is the other part of the network where the things are connected. But till here, if I assume at this point, this has node A and this has node B. Okay. So if I assume that some voltage drop is there, that is Vx, then if I assume that some current is flowing, that is Ix. Okay. So then if I apply KVL in a clockwise direction, what I will get is this equation. Okay. So I hope now everyone are familiar with the how to write KVL equation. So I have minus Vs, then this voltage drop is Ix into R, plus Vx. Plus Vx because we have assumed the voltage drop here, so this we have to assume. Then we can define Vx equal to this value. So what I told is, you can convert this into equivalent current source. So how the current source can be represented? A current source in parallel with the same resistance value. So this resistance value and this resistance value should be same, they will not change. Okay. So it is nothing but like writing V equal to I into R is same as I equal to V by R. This resistance value will remain same. Okay. So similarly here, if you apply KCL at node N, so if I assume that a voltage source has been converted into current source, that is nothing but a voltage source in series with resistance is converted to a current source in parallel with the same resistance. So if I assume here this node N, and if I assume that current is I, which is flowing through that branch, and other parameters are same, still we have the node A here, point A and point B, and voltage drop across this is still same, Vx. So by KCL I can write Is is equal to what now? I plus Ix, because Is is this current which is entering, I is this current which is leaving, and Ix is also a current which is leaving. Then what will be the voltage drop? How to define this voltage drop? V is equal to I into R, right? So voltage drop is nothing but this voltage drop. You have to go parallelly like this. So here you find which current. Current is I and resistance is R, right? So this will be the voltage drop across this. So Vx I can define it as I into R, right? So now if you solve it further, you see that we get I is equal to Is minus Ix, and Vx will be what? Now I have taken Vx definition here. Vx will be equal to what is I? I is nothing but Is minus Ix into R. So if you substitute, you will get another equation. Now if you compare equation 1 and equation 2 with each other, so we see that this Ix into R and Ix into R will get cancelled out, and still we can prove that the Vs value is nothing but Is into R, right? Or nothing but I is equal to V by R. The same definition holds here also. Okay, so what is the definition for any current here, or the voltage, source current or source voltage? Source voltage Vs is nothing but what? Source current, that is the current generated by this source, I can assume this as Ix, multiplied by R, right? So this is the concept here. So next we will look into the source shifting method. So the earlier method is source transformation. Now we have the source shifting. So when do we take source shifting here? So source shifting we consider whenever we find that source transformation is not possible from our end. So we can take source shifting. Okay, so now if you consider this circuit here, for example, okay, so this circuit, you can see that we have a voltage source, and to this voltage source we have three impedances connected. They are not in series. So if you have only one resistor connected with one voltage source, so this can be converted into an equivalent current source followed by the same resistor. But here we don't have the provision to convert this voltage source into a current source, but we can use the basic laws here. We know what is the voltage drop across node X. So voltage drop at X is nothing but it is E volts, this voltage. Suppose if I assume something like 5 volts, so this will be 5, right? So I should make it convenient to change this network so that it will be suitable for source transformation. But keep in mind that we should not change the characteristics of the circuit. So how it is done? So we know that this point is X, so you can shift this to each of the impedances. So if I consider only this one, so you can see that X is shifted, it has been taken back to that impedance. But other point, other side of the network, it is connected to ground. So this was grounded, so this is nothing but zero. So still we can see that the voltage drop here is the same, right? Similarly, you can push the other side also. This X you can take it this side, and the same point you can take it this side. So X is taken everywhere, and we have attached a voltage source, right? So it will be convenient if we have a voltage source in series with some impedance. Impedance means it can be a resistance, inductance or capacitance, or the combination also. So now I can convert any of these combination to equivalent current source. So I can equivalently write something like IE in parallel with Z3. Okay, So this is how we can convert it, and here you can have the node C, and still this will be acting like a node X. So everywhere you can convert it. So similarly, if you consider here, so you will get another parallel combination, and here also you will get another parallel combination of the current and the equivalent impedance. Sorry, this will be Z1, this will be Z2. So you can call this as A and this point as B, and this is grounded. Okay, so is that clear to everyone? So if you have any questions, you can ask. Okay, so shall I proceed to the next? So similarly, on the same basis, we can opt for the current source shift also. So that we call it as I shift. Okay, so if you consider this I shift here, so this is the main circuit. This is the main circuit we can consider. So first you observe here, what are the characteristics? So we have different points here, 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 and as well as here. So if I label them something like A, B, C, and D. So now we see that everywhere again they are diverted to some other part of the network. So keeping this in mind, now what we can say is we see that current source is not in parallel with the any of the impedances directly, right? So how that current can flow? So we know that this loop, so in this loop this current will flow. Or if you follow the direction of the current, we can say outer loop also we can have this current. So what is the direction here? Current is flowing from, the direction is like this, A to D, A to D in the outer loop. And if you consider in the same way, it has to start from A and it has to end at D. So A to D we can have for outer loop, we can have the traversing from A to B, then B to C, then C to D. Or otherwise we can have one more short path, that is A to B, then B to D. So that is shown here. So shortest path is this, A to B, then B to D. Okay, sorry, this not this one, here we have that. So this is the first condition what we have. Let me erase, sorry here. Okay, so if you consider the first point, this is the point where we have the path A to B, B to C, and C to D. So this is how we can represent the current source direction. And shortest path is this one. You can use this also, A to B, then B to D. So if I modify the circuit in this way, either this way or this way, the behavior of the circuit will not change. So it is still the same, but what we have done is we have made it convenient to apply source transformation. So now we can apply source transformation. I can convert this voltage source in parallel with Z1 as, sorry, a current source in parallel with Z1 as equivalent voltage source equivalent voltage source in series with Z1. Yes, so where they can be replaced across point D and C. So similarly, you can apply it here also and here also. Or if you use this, still you can use this, right? So this is the concept here of overall entire source transformation and source shifting. And now, if you come back to a few clues before I start with the actual problems, so you need to keep few things in mind. So first thing, we will explore about the voltage sources. If you have the voltage sources, so which all conditions we can see. So first thing is, for independent voltage source, we use the symbol like this, right? And if you have the dependent voltage source, we can use the voltage source representation like this. So this can be current controlled or voltage controlled, so it depends on the condition. So this is the second condition. Now if you consider the condition for voltage, so we can have the voltage drops whenever you have the open circuit. Okay, so that is, we need to have open circuit for voltage drop. Fourth one is, now if you have two voltage sources connected in series, assume that V1 and V2, so what will be the equivalent voltage source? So equivalent voltage source value will be plus minus V1 plus V2. I will call this as V equivalent. But the question here is, you need to understand the polarity. So whether we should take plus minus or minus plus. So here no need to worry, because we have the same polarity and as well as the same values also, if you assume V1 and V2. Okay, suppose if we have this condition, plus minus, and here just check if we have V1, but here this is something like minus V2. Suppose then here no doubt that the equivalent value will be V1 plus of minus V2, but the polarity here, it depends on the highest magnitude of the source. Okay, so that means what? Suppose if this is 1 volt and this is 2, that is minus 2. So then 1 plus of minus 2, that will result into what? Minus 1. So polarity will change in that case. Okay, so the same thing, if it is like 2 and 1, so for this case the polarity will be 2 plus of minus 1, that is nothing but 1, positive 1, plus and minus. So this is how the polarity will change. So this we have to keep in mind. So is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
So if you have any doubts, please ask. Please make the things clear now only. Okay. See, these are not the question paper conditions. These are the conditions which will occur in the problems. So you need to have a very basics to be very strong. So don't hesitate.
Sir.
Yes, please.
Oh. What if both have same polarity?
Same polarity, okay. same polarity I told, no, just now, this one.
I mean, sir, both have 2 and 2, like same numbers.
Okay, let shall I take this fourth one as an example? I will take V1 equal to 2 and V2 equal to 2. In this way, are you telling?
Yes, sir.
So 2 plus 2, so this will be what? V1 is how much? 2. V2 is how much? 2. So this will be 4 volts. Yeah, is that clear?
Yeah. No, sir. In other case.
Okay, so just tell me the values V1 and V2.
If it is plus 2 and minus 2.
V1 is plus 2 and V2 is minus 2. So you have 2 voltage sources. So what about polarity here? How you want to have polarity? Plus and minus or minus and plus?
Plus and minus.
Okay, so don't hesitate. You can tell. No need to worry. Both, shall I take plus and minus? No. Okay. So you are defining V1 as 2. V2 is already mentioned as minus 2. So is that correct according to you, your imagination, what you are telling?
Yes, sir.
So this equivalent voltage source you want, right? So first thing is, we know both voltage sources are in series. They are in series, so they will add up anyway, right? So we need to write V1 plus V2. So don't worry about this magnitude right now. So what is V1? It is 2. Plus, what is the magnitude here? It is minus 2. So this is going to be 0 volts. So 0 volts means, here since we have the same polarity, means same magnitude, so 0 voltage is represented with what? Short circuit. Right? So no need to represent a voltage source here. So if equivalent voltage is 0, that will be a short. Okay, if it is infinite, it will be an open. Yes, what's your name?
Sir, Disha.
Okay, I hope I have cleared your doubt.
Yes.
Okay, good. Anyway, so
thank you, sir.
Okay, no issues. So this kind of conversation will help us also, and help you also. Okay. Fine. So any other questions from any other students? See, voltage source and current source, they are the active elements. RLC, they are the passive elements. So you should be active. You should not be passive. Okay, so shall I proceed?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. See, many conditions will occur. So, these are the few cases. Similarly, if you consider for the current source also. So, what is the nature of the current source if you take? So with the similar conditions, first one for current source, what, how we represent is like this, right? Where this arrowhead, it indicates the polarity positive, this tail indicates the polarity as negative. And what about for dependent conditions? Again, the same thing, we may have like this, or we may have the representation like this. It can be a current controlled current source or voltage controlled current source. Okay, and condition for current to flow, how the current will flow. So no doubt that current will flow from higher potential to lower potential, but it requires a closed path. So if we have a short circuit, then we can say current is maximum, and if you have the open circuit, we say current is zero. Okay, and Okay, I forgot to tell here for voltage source, we should not connect two voltage sources in parallel. That is not allowed until and unless their voltage drops are same. Okay, otherwise it is going to create a short and that circuit may burn out also. Okay, so similarly here, if you consider the current source, first condition is you can't have two current sources connected in series, because we know in a single branch same current will flow. Again, the same condition, until and unless if these values are same, then only we can connect, otherwise it is not allowed. So condition is always we need to have current sources in parallel. So similarly here, what will be the equivalent value now? It will be, no doubt, it will be adding up I1 and I2. So equivalent will be I1 plus I2. So what about the direction? The same concept here also. If both are same, if I assume like 2 amps and 2 amps, or maybe 3 amps, 2 plus 3, that will be 5 amps. So direction will be same. So if I have another condition, like the one current source is like this, if I use this as minus 2 amps, label is minus 2 amps, and if I have another current direction which is labeled as 3 amps, so no doubt it will be added up and it will result into one current source, that is minus 2 plus 3 is equal to 1 amps. But out of these two, which one is having the highest magnitude? Highest magnitude current source is 3. So we have to consider, or you have to prefer that current direction. So this will be the direction. So if it is something like minus 3 here as well, so again minus 3, minus 2 plus of minus 3, that is going to give us what? Minus 5. Again, in that case also, we need to consider this direction only, but value will be minus 5. Okay. So, is that clear to everyone? So that we can proceed for the numericals. So if you have any questions to be asked, please ask here, okay? Okay, so already I have floated a few questions here, and I have asked you to note down these questions, right? So first question, if you check here, what is the condition given? So for the given network, you need to find current through 2 ohm resistor. So we are interested in finding the current through this 2 ohm resistor. So that means this resistor we have to retain. It should be retained as it is. So other things you can use the other elements to apply the source transformation. Okay, and here you can see we have a dependent current source, and its value depends on the voltage Vx. Where is that voltage Vx? It is across 2 ohms, right? And let us first observe the circuit. So these observations we have done, and what is the requirement? We need to find the current. So we need to define the current here. So current through, current through 2 ohm resistor, how we can define? So we have plus and minus and Vx. So if you assume the passive sign convention, that is the current flowing from higher potential to lower potential, we can define I is equal to V by R. or first if we define what is voltage Vx, Vx will be 2 times I, whatever current it comes here, okay? Then I is equal to Vx by 2. So first we check out where we can apply source transformation. And what are the conditions for source transformation? So if you want to convert a current source, into voltage source, first thing is we need to have current source in parallel with some impedance. And if you want to convert voltage source into current source, we need to have a voltage source in series with some impedance. Okay, this is one condition. And you should look into the circuit and check whether you have more number of current source or more number of voltage source. If you find that more number of current sources are there, you can go for current source to voltage source conversion. And if you find that more number of voltage sources are there, then you can go for voltage source to current source conversion. So now if you study here, first thing you understand here, we have 5 amps connected in parallel with 3 ohms and as well as 9 ohms connected in parallel with 1 ampere. So if I consider only this part, one part of the network, so if I consider this, so what I will get is, I will get this. And if I assume that this point is something like X and this point is something like Y, okay, so we have at X we have this condition 3 and 5, this is connected to X, okay. So this I can convert it into equivalent voltage source. How to convert this? Use the Ohm's law, V equal to I into R, right? And check the direction here, direction of the current source. This is very important. It is going towards X, means head indicates positive, tail indicates negative. So voltage will be 5 into 3, that will be 15 with this polarity. And the series resistor, and this point will be X. Okay, got this one, everyone? So it is very important that this head you have to indicate. So similarly, if you consider the arrow mark here, arrow mark is towards Y. So if you convert this thing to voltage source, 9 into 1, that will be how much? 9 volts with positive polarity towards the point Y. So now I can redraw this circuit like this. Okay. So I have a point X where I can use this 3 ohm resistor, then followed by plus and minus 15 volts. And you can check here, from X it is connected to 4 ohms, right? So then we have this split up. So that is, we have 17 ohm resistor. Then we have this dependent current source, that is 3Vx. And here we have 7 ohms. Okay. Then we have this. Oh, sorry. Okay. So after this, we have 2 ohm resistor, and here we have this point Y. So at this point Y, what we need to replace? We need to replace it with 9 ohm followed by this 9 volt source. Okay. So is that clear to everyone? How we have transformed this network into this?
Yes, sir.
So do not hesitate to ask the question, please. Okay. So second step will be what now? We need to calculate the voltage, sorry, current through this. So this parameter should not be changed anyway. But here you can see that these 3 ohms and 4 ohm, they are in series. 3 plus 4, that will be 7. So this will be 7 ohms, right? And next, what we have here, two elements, current source and this ohm, 17 ohm resistor, they are in parallel. You can convert this into a voltage source. So this is nothing but what? This I can redraw this here in a more clear way. So I will just take out a few things here. Okay, so if I redraw this circuit again back here, okay, so what I can get here is I have the 15 volt source, then followed by the two resistors. If you sum up, this will be 7 ohms, and from here we have the this dependent source, current source, in parallel with 17 ohm. 17 into 3, that will be 51 Vx. So this will be the voltage source value with the polarity like this. Then this 17 ohm we can consider like this here. Okay, so this I can include it here. So after this 7 ohms, what I have, right? So this can be replaced by a voltage source of the value 51 Vx. It is a dependent voltage source, sorry. Then followed by what we have is 17 ohms. Then, as usual, the 2 ohm resistor with the labels Vx given here. Then I get a 9 ohm resistor with plus or minus 9 volts. So, still you can redraw this in a better way. So, next, here, this circuit you can convert it into next thing. So here what we can observe is, again we have a voltage source in series with this. So this can be converted into a current source, so that we get this 7 and 7 in parallel. Okay. So if we do that, if I consider only this part and if I apply it here, so current will be, that is 15 divided by 7, that will turn out into how much? 2.15. okay, yes, is that clear? So this current source, I can show it here something like this. What is the direction? Direction is like this. This will be 2.5. then what we have is this 7 ohms and another 7 ohms. Then we have this dependent source with these polarities with the value 51 Vx, and here you see that 17 and 9, they are in series, so you should not add, you should not disturb this 2 ohm resistor. So 17 plus 9, that is going to give us 26 ohms, then followed by this 2 ohm plus and minus Vx. Then what we have is this voltage source. Okay. So in a similar way, now we can again see that we can still apply the source transformation, but here you have this parallel combination of 7 and 7. So in the series and parallel combination of resistor, we have seen if you have two resistors connected in parallel, their equivalent resistance will be half of that. So this will be 3.5. So if you remember, yes, any questions? So if you remember this principle, so no need to again calculate. Okay, it is valid only for equal values, so not for other values. Okay, so if I take it back now, I can redraw, or I can replace this with 3.5. so 3.5 and this 2.5, now they are coming in parallel with each other. So this I can again redraw the circuit something like this. So let me clear a few things here. Okay, so our requirement is, so we need to convert this into an equivalent voltage source. So what is the equivalent voltage source value? That is 2.5 is it 2.5 or 2.15? Just check out. 2.5,
sir. Yeah, 2.5.
No, I think it is
2.15,
I guess.
2.15.
2.15, sir. Okay, so this is 2.15. 2.15 into 3.5, you have to do 2.15 into, so that you will get a voltage source. So this I am taking back here. So check the polarity. The arrow was upwards, so we get the voltage source plus and minus with the value 7.5. you can take approximately 7, it is 7.525, you can make it 7.5, no issues. in series with 3.5 ohms this resistor, then remaining elements are the same things, minus plus 51 Vx, then we have 26 ohms, then we have this 2 ohms where Vx is mentioned, then we have this 9 volts. Okay, so now we have reduced this entire circuit into a single loop circuit. So but what is the requirement? We need to find the current through this 2 ohm resistor. So here I can assume a clockwise current as I. Current will flow from higher potential to lower potential. I am assuming it as I. And if you apply KVL to the entire loop starting from this point, so what I have? Minus 7.5 plus 3.5 I. Then this is the voltage source, minus 51 Vx, then we have 26 here plus 26 I. So here you can consider Vx as well. Okay, so for a while I will take only Vx. So why, you will come to know anyway, because in order to find the current you need to find the value of Vx. Okay, so if you take that also instead of 26 I, then followed by plus Vx, then plus 9 equal to 0. So from the circuit we know already, we can observe that what is Vx. See, there are two unknown parameters, I and Vx. So if you want to find current through 2 ohm resistor, you need to find what now? Vx. But what is Vx? Vx is 2 times I. So wherever you have Vx, you can replace Vx with 2 times I so that you can calculate current. Otherwise, what is the requirement in other way? You can replace I wherever you have I. This can be replaced by Vx by 2. So here also we have this. This can be replaced by Vx by 2. Okay. So you will get this equation. So from this equation you can find what is Vx. You calculate that. Then use that Vx value in the equation I equal to Vx by 2, so that you will get the total current in amps. Okay, so can you do this, solve this equation and come out with the Vx value and I value? Is that clear to everyone?
Yes sir.
Okay, so okay, so please proceed for that and calculate and let me know the Vx value. So for your reference, I will just write this equation once again. Minus 7.5 plus 3.5 Vx divided by 2, minus 51 Vx. Plus 26 Vx by 2 plus Vx minus, sorry, plus 9. Okay, so can anyone get me the Vx value? So this turns out to be 1.75, and this one is 13. Thank you.